bishop, obviously the support of the annual appeal. And every year, where our goal here is 34,000, and we make the goal every year, or at least come close to it anyway, 99% or whatever. So again, I know I can count on you to do your part. It's regarding, you know, to support the ministries of the diocese as the appeal. You can see that in the Catholic Life, or you could go on the website, dioceseofscranton.org, and you can follow along what the appeal supports. Clergy, seminarians, like Andrew in the seminary right now. When I was in the seminary, the annual appeal supported my education. The diocese paid for that through the annual appeal. Catholic Social Services, the Catholic Schools, and so forth. So various percentages of the annual appeal every year supports the ministries of the diocese in the 11 counties that comprise of the Diocese of Scranton. So let us pay attention now to this annual appeal video, and then we'll start the Mass.
Consider a gift to the 2,000. parish. Thank you as well for the many ways you bring life to your local church through the work of the diocesan annual appeal. Pledge cards are available in your parish right now. Please take a few moments to fill one out. And please, be as generous as you are able. Gifts of all sizes are needed and appreciated to fulfill our mission. Please know that you and your family remain in my prayers always.
God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world.
and make those hastening to attain your promises heirs to the treasures of heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord, you say, the Lord's way is not fair. Hear now, house of Israel. Is it my way that is unfair? Or rather, are not your ways unfair? When someone virtuous turns away from virtue to commit iniquity and dies, it is because of the iniquity he committed that he must die. But if he turns from wickedness he has committed and does what is right and just, he shall preserve his life, since he has turned away from all the sins that he has committed. He shall surely live, he shall not die. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please join in singing our response for our song, found on page 67 in the Missalette. Each looking out, not for his own interests,
but also for those of others. Have in you the same attitude that is also in Christ Jesus, the Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Another said he will go, but he never went. And so, again, we have to be able to put on the mind of Christ in doing what God requires and asks of each and every one of us, for ourselves, our families, and particularly, as we're talking about the annual appeal, others. We always have to have others. That's the purpose of the church. The purpose of the church is to minister with the mind of Christ to others, especially those who are in need or those who are less fortunate. And so again, all we have to do is do our part. Don't ask, is it fair or is it not? Because that's not up to us to bargain with God when it comes to the things of God and requiring us to have the mind of Christ in our service to others. Otherwise, we have to change our minds and we have to do what God asks and requires of us so that others can appreciate the good that comes from our blessing and our abundance in service to one another. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God,
to unify in community in his name. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may be called to support ministries of our church through the diocesan annual appeal, that through our participation, we continue to be chaplains of the living and loving presence of Christ. Let us pray through the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died in Christ, for Mary Connor, the Pouches, and the Halchick families, for whom this Mass is being offered, and for others who would like to remember. Let us pray to the Lord.
We ask these prayers always in faith through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please join in singing our song during the preparation of the gifts. Here I am, Lord. Now in the celebrate hymnal, number 834.
Lord, God of all,
He took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Amen.
all the poor quarantines of the world, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, honor, glory. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us share a sign.
Please join in singing our song during communion, "The Supper of the Lord," found in the book insert, number 29.
Thank you.
Francis is on October the 4th, and so tomorrow, 12 noon, will be at Exaltation, and 1 o'clock here in the parking lot, the blessing of all of your favorite pets tomorrow. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace. Have a good evening and Sunday.
Please join in singing, Holy God, we praise thy name. Now that we celebrate in hymn number 952.
Thank you. Hi, John.
Hi, Chuck.